I'm gonna show you how to do the Saber outline effect in After Effects. Stop by clicking on the first link in the description to come to this website and download the free plugin for After Effects. Once you download the plugin, go to After Effects, select your clip, then duplicate it by pressing Ctrl and D. Now go to the top left tool's rectangle, click and hold, and select the ellipse tool. Once you selected the tool, make sure the top layer is selected, then hold Shift while dragging to scale the circle evenly. Now click on the selection tool in the top left, then reposition the circle by clicking on these handles. You can zoom into the preview by using the scroll wheel and the mouse, or simply adjusting the zoom down here. Now adjust the circle to the object you want to outline, in my case it's this rim, and you can do this by double clicking on these buttons and then adjusting it. Make sure the top layer is selected, then click M and right click on mask 1 and click on track mask. This tracker window should now pop up, but if it doesn't work, then click on window and make sure tracker is selected. Click on the play button and it should automatically start to track the mask. Once it's done tracking every frame, we can see that it have tracked the mask really good. Now let's add the Saber effect by going to the effects and preset panel and simply search Saber and drag it to your top clip. Once you apply the effect, we can see that we have a little Saber on the preview window. Now go to the effects panel under Saber, expand customize core, and on the core type, change it to layer mask. Now go to the bottom to render settings and expand it and change the composite settings to transparent. We have now already created the outline for the effect. But now let's start doing the animation. Now go to the effects panel and under preset, you can choose any preset that you want. It doesn't matter which one you choose because you can always change it later on. You can also customize the color by clicking on glow color and then changing it to the one you want. And just because I have a red car, I'm gonna choose a red color. I'll go back to the customize core settings and change the start size to 0 so you get this sort of fade effect on your outline. Now keyframe mask evolution while making sure that you're the start of the clip. Then you can show the keyframe by clicking on the layer and pressing U, and then simply move the player to the end of the clip and then change the evolution settings to how much you want. The higher the number, the faster the animation will go. In my case, this animation will go really fast because I chose a high number. You can obviously slow down the animation by making sure that you're on the last keyframe, then decrease in the evolution settings. We now have this more slow animation. You can also adjust the trail size by going back to effects controls and changing the end offset value to whatever you like. The lower the number, the less of a trail you'll see. For a little bonus, I'm going to show you how to do this rainbow effect. We go to effects and preset panel and search color balance, then drag the color balance HLS effect to top clip in the timeline. Now in effects controls, scroll down to color balance and keyframe U while making sure that the start of the clip, then move the player to the end of the clip and then change the hue value to whatever you like. If you found this video helpful or learned something new, please subscribe and click on the next video for another tutorial.